Hello,
你好. I am Amanda Hsiung-Blodgett, Miss Panda, and this is Playful Chinese. This is a culture episode. I have a special guest. Amy Wang Lao Shi is an English teacher in China. We're going to talk about the Chinese Mid-Autumn Festival. Many people think the Mid-Autumn Festival, 中秋节, is similar to Thanksgiving. Come and find out. I call her Wang Lao Shi. Wang is her last name. Lao Shi is how Chinese people call their teachers. Teacher, 老师, old master, 老师. Chinese people respect teachers very much. 老师. There are two parts in this interview. The first part is in English, and the second part is in Mandarin Chinese. I hope you enjoyed it, and explore the Chinese culture with us. Hi, Amy. Can you tell us where you are right now?
I'm in Heilongjiang province of China.
Is that where you grew up?
Yes, this is my hometown.
That is amazing. So I'm so excited to talk to you, and we're going to talk about the Chinese Mid-Autumn Festival. And you're going to share with us about how Chinese people in China celebrate this festival. So do you always see some kind of special food or gift box before the arrival of the Mid-Autumn Festival?
Mooncakes pop out of my mind first, because it's the most popular traditional food we eat during Mid-Autumn Festival. And the second most important thing is the family reunion, because the round moon represent the harmony of the family. So it's the second most important festival next to the Chinese Spring Festival. And also, and many beautiful stories about the festival, why we celebrate.
That is so true. And then is there always a special family meal on the Moon Festival? Do people have barbecues, or is there anything special people eat for like a dinner on the Mid-Autumn Festival?
Exactly. We have the family feast. We cook all kinds of a large variety of different of dishes. And barbecue, and sometimes we do barbecue, but not always.
And then you are in the northern part of China. So is there any special celebration you usually see in Heilongjiang province for the Moon Festival?
Well, Mid-Autumn Festival has some special points here. Like it's much colder than the southern part of China. We are going to wear warm clothes. And besides the clothes, the food, I guess we prefer the salty food, salty mooncakes. Compared with the southern part, they prefer the meat mooncakes.
So how cold is it usually on the Moon Festival?
I think it's closer to the, it's pretty the same. The beginning part of winter in Maryland.
Okay, I want to talk about the mooncake you're talking about, the salty mooncakes and the meat mooncakes. That is really different from the southern part, because the southern part of China, and people love to have the sweet mooncake. So the salty ones, what's inside? What kind of meat? How do you prepare that? If you can kind of give us a simple idea about that.
You know, because I know American people, they prefer the Guangdong province style mooncakes, and some Hong Kong famous brand mooncakes. But here we have like the spicy beef, and sometimes the different nuts inside, and also low sugar one for the diabetes. So it's around 100 different flavors.
But when you were younger, your family, what's your family's favorite mooncake filling? Or
The most traditional one is the five different nuts one. In Chinese, 五仁月饼. 五仁 means five different nuts.
So 五仁月饼, we're talking about the five different nuts kind of mooncakes, and with like a sticky and sugary kind of filling. Is that correct?
Yes, and Chinese people of our generation make fun of it because it's sugar and fat. You know, the nuts has fat, and so we don't understand how could this food, stay in our life for such a long time.
Thank you for sharing that with us. So do people really take a walk and go look at the moon and or appreciate the moon on the moon festival in your province or like overall in China?
All over in China, because we have the most famous song and also the poem written by a poet. And I don't know if my translation is correct, but it means no matter where you are, we share the same moon. So the moon is always a symbol of missing hometown. Homesick people use moon as a way to express their missing home. So the Mid-Autumn Festival always make people very sensitive and miss their motherland.
That is so true. And then the beautiful poem, would you share that with us in Chinese, in Mandarin?
千里共婵娟.
Yeah, so basically it's no matter how many miles or how thousands of miles away from home, we're still looking at the same moon. So it is a very, like you said, it can be very emotional and can be people who have been traveling. And actually, when we talk about like people do look at moon, and there's a term for that. Is that what you say? 赏月. Do you also say that in China?
Yes. Because when you look at the moon, people always notice there are some black dots on the moon, and we have very beautiful fairy tales about it. Like the lady called Chang'e, he separated with his husband Hou Yi, and Chang'e is staying alone on the moon planet with his rabbit as a mascot. There's a guy called Wu Gang. Is always cutting the trees, but he never succeed cutting it. That's why people wonder if these tales are true when we appreciate the moon.
All the Chinese children, even when we were little, we were told about these folk tales about Chang'e Beng Yue. So it's like the moon lady, the Chinese moon lady, and then her companion, the jade rabbit, Yu Tu. And then you brought another fascinating story about Wu Gang, the tree cutter.
And my daughter has two doubts. Two questions. She's been wondering the real answer. The first one is, she asked me, Mom, is there a real Chang'e on the moon? I said, yes, maybe. And she said, when I grow up, I want to see if there's Chang'e on the moon on my own. And then I asked her, do you believe in Christmas man, Santa Claus? She said, of course, because Santa Claus gave me the socks with the present I like. one time, but Chang'e didn't give me anything yet.
That is such an interesting and fun story from the young mind. The imagination is the key here, isn't it? I think the stories always give us imagination. A good story will encourage kids to find out on their own. Well, I think we have an astronaut in the making.
Yeah, to explore the unknown.
So now we're going to talk about the story, the question in Chinese. 哎，你好，我现在在中国的黑龙江省。是，在黑龙江过去就是俄国了，俄罗斯了。所以我们好高兴今天可以和你连线。我们今天要说一说中秋节，在中国大家怎么样庆祝中秋节？所以中秋节快到的时候，在 北京在中国是不是都会看到什么特别的食物或者是礼盒呢？
对的，我们会看到月饼的礼盒。月饼的礼盒，那这是在中秋节那天大家是不是都会吃月饼呢？ 是的，因为其实我们还有一些，比如说茶叶和月饼的礼盒。 因为就是叫看月，品茶吃月饼，是中国的传统，在中秋节的时候。是，月饼是什么形状的？有什么口味？老师可不可以跟大家介绍一下？好的，月饼呢，现在有方形的，有正方形，有圆形，那么像口味的话，现在南北的差异也比较大。
比如说北方就有很多咸味的月饼，包括这个，但是无论南北，五仁月饼都是最重要的一个口味，我觉得。老师说的时候觉得很好笑，五仁月饼为什么这么有趣呢？要不要说一下？因为五仁月饼在我的小的时候呢，是一个。 就是大家都会吃到的，虽然我们都不太喜欢吃，但是它是一个特别经典的口味。就是因为像枣泥啊、豆沙呀、五仁呢、啊，这种是中国的老式月饼的常见的一种口味，在北方叫北方老月饼。但是在我的应该是十年前左右的时候，这个五仁月饼就变成了一种大家调侃的。
或者是开玩笑的一个口味，蛮红的，大家都流行的，所以大家开始开玩笑了。那开玩笑是因为什么？它太甜了吗？还是为什么呢？可能就我猜是因为坚果很油，还和糖在一起就很腻，让人觉得有点吃不下太多，可能一口的热量都很高，就饱了。
这个说的好，我们要小心，别吃太多月饼了。那老师，在中秋节那一天，大家是不是都聚在一起吃一个特别的餐点呢？比如说在晚上，是不是会煮的特别丰盛的晚餐，然后让大家全家人可以团聚在一起呢？
对的，就是叫团圆宴、家宴，那么是仅次于春节的。
一次很大的家庭聚会，所以中秋节是在春节之后最重要的一个节日，大家也会特别聚在一起，然后一起吃饭。那讲到这个家庭的这个部分，那是不是住在很远地方的这些游子啊，在外地工作的人也都有机会赶回家和大家一起吃这个团圆饭或家聚呢？
这个就要视情况而定了，因为如果一年中只有一次机会的话，那一定是留给春节；如果一年中有两次机会的话，那我想一定能到中秋节了。
是，那中秋节那天在中国，大家真的会去赏月，去散步赏月吗？
会的，就是今天晚上我就已经开始赏月了，虽然它还不是最远的时候。
是，听说你有一个小故事，你女儿问的问题很有意思，因为我们知道，中国的中秋节有很多美丽的传说的故事，那其中有一个是嫦娥奔月的故事，你要不要大概跟我们提一下呢？
嗯，好的，嗯，嫦娥奔月是，嗯，后羿呢，曾经，嗯，天上有十个太阳，然后后羿呢就，太阳他晒把人们都晒死。快晒死了，然后后羿就去射掉了九个太阳，最后留下了一个太阳。所以后羿呢，就因为他这种英雄的事迹呢，就被王母娘娘奖励了两颗仙丹，说如果你吃一颗的话，就可以长生不老；吃两颗的话，就可以升天飞仙。然后后羿就把这两颗仙丹交给了他妻子嫦娥保管。有一天，后羿在教学生们射箭的时候，他的其中一个学生叫彭蒙，然后呢他就总想把这个仙丹吞下，然后就变得长生不老，于是他就假装生病。那么在后羿领着他的学生出去打猎的时候呢，彭蒙就偷偷的留下来，然后威胁嫦娥说要把这个仙丹抢走。嫦娥知道彭蒙是坏蛋，在情急之下呢，就把这个仙丹两颗都吞进了肚子里，于是他飘飘升仙。后来他成为仙女之后呢，选择了离家最近的一个天宫的位置，就是月球。所以后羿知道自己的妻子为了保护这个仙丹，然后已经在月球上面了，在月亮上面，他就远远的看着，就看到了嫦娥，所以他就开始在下面做月饼，表达对嫦娥的思念之情。
好有趣的一个故事，可是你的小女儿特别问了你，天上真的有嫦娥吗？是不是？她怎么发现这个问题的呢？
就是她看着月亮，她就会有一天，她会问，妈妈，你相信月球上真的有嫦娥吗？然后我说，对呀，我说我相信啊，我说那你可以长大了自己去。作为宇航员上去看一看是不是真的有嫦娥。然后我因为他怀疑这个月球上，就是怀疑月亮上的这个嫦娥的故事，我又追问了一个问题，我问那你相信有圣诞老人吗？他说当然了，圣诞老人给过我礼物，可是嫦娥什么也没有给过我。
这是一个真可爱的一个故事。谢谢严明老师今天和我们分享中秋节的故事，谢谢你。
我很开心，我真的很开心和你聊这些话题。
Joy multiplies when it is shared. You can rate, review, and share Playful Chinese on all podcast platforms. Come and join us next time for more Playful Chinese. This is Miss Panda, and I'll see you next time. 我们下次见。